Very.
Yeah, make the commitment now. You know, you gotta want it. I don't think there's ever been a time when you guys might want to carry this on. I don't think there's ever been a time when Greenwood lost to a team that they were supposed to lose to, or they beat a team that they weren't supposed to. It's always been the, you know, the other way. But we're always supposed to beat every team we play. That's how you gotta look at it.
You gotta carry on the tradition like me and Mad Dog Bear have. I have a presentation here. This right here was handed down to me by one of the greats. Of course, he's my brother, and he really wasn't that great. But this is the last year they had one of these jerseys. And it's always been something special. Everybody always wants one. And I'm going to hand it down to somebody I really think is a good player and really works hard, has good hard work ethics. And that is Mr. CJ Cash. Way to go, CJ.
I mean, I hope that I have a better memory in this season, but my best so far was when I was the little freshman in my first varsity game when we, I don't remember, I think it was like South Dearborn or something, but we traveled forever, it seemed like. And I remember I was sitting there waiting on the sidelines, you know, cheering for the team and everything. And right at the end of the game, I got in, got the ball a couple times. I don't know, it was just something about the, I don't know, being a part of that team that I thought was real neat, because I didn't think, you know, I'd really earned it yet, and I don't know, I thought it was just pretty neat.
I think one of my most memorable moments, this is going to show how few I've really had, but it was just this year against Brownsburg. I had a lot of memorable moments on that because our defense just really stuck it to them, but I'd say the interception I got in return for 50 yards. No, it was 40 yards. I take that back, it's 40 yards.
It probably would have been 50, but...
It'd have been 50 if I was so tired, but when I tapped that ball up and I caught it, that just, it was cool.
I think it was just because you're tired and you couldn't use your 4-3 speed.
Right. I couldn't use my...
I'm Brian Klotz, and I'm graduating this year from Greenwood football, and I'd like to share some of my most memorable experiences with you. And some of them are when I was quarterback, it's my sophomore year for the reserve team. And across the line would be Jamie Washell, Snodgrass, Harris, Montgomery, just to name a few, Sean Wolf. And then, of course, during it'd be Wednesday practices, varsity goes on defense. And so our reserve is the offense for the varsity. And we represent the team they're gonna play and try to run the plays like how they run them and everything. And so Mr. Scott would put me in a red jersey and warned the defensive line not to hit me. But every time I seemed I'd end up on the ground harder than the next. And I'd yell at my line, and they still make fun of me every once in a while. Like Wild Bill, he still yells at me. And I'd yell at them and all that stuff, and they'd just come through and nail me. But now, see, now it's my turn to nail the younger guys, the sophomores, like Chad White. But every time I get a chance to nail them, the coaches get all mad. And they say that we're not supposed to hit them, that they know we're there, and just let them throw the ball on all this. So I maybe get in one good hit on a quarterback during practice. And after that, I get in trouble. And just preparing for Greenwood football, you have to take it serious. You have to work out during the summer. You have to try to do things with the team, such as agilities and car push and stuff like that. It means a lot. And it will make a difference come season. And one of my greatest accomplishments for preseason was making the 1,000-pound club. Over the past, I'd say, 2 years, I started working real hard at my strength, and it's shown. And now I'm in the 1,000 Pound Club now, along with many other people. That's one of my best accomplishments for preseason football. And I'd like to pass something down to Scott Jared. These are the wristbands which Dominique Batnall gave me after they lost in the regional game against Lafayette Harrison. And so I'm going to pass these down to Scott Jared. And, you know, hopefully after he has a season and wears these every game, then he'll pass them down to somebody and we'll just keep on continuing, hopefully. But that's all I have to say. And good luck to all the freshmen and reserve football players coming up. And before you know it, it's over. Because it seems like it goes by so fast. And we have one more regular season game, and I can't believe it. And I'd also like to thank the coaches for all their time and effort. And they're good coaches, and they know what they're talking about. Like Mr. Scott will tell you how many years of experience they all have combined, and he'll bring up all these games from the 60s and 50s. And they have some good stories, and they spend a lot of good quality time preparing us for each game coming up. And that's all I have to say. Thank you.
I'm Alex Talley. I'm a defensive lineman for Greenwood. Senior here, 94. It's been real short, it seems, that I've had a lot of fun and a lot of hard work going put into it. I'd like to congratulate Mr. Scott for his 150th win against Plainfield of this year. That was a good win for all of us. We needed it. We actually looked like a football team. We pulled together and actually kicked some butt there. I'd like to thank all the coaches for all the time and effort they've put in. I'd like to thank all the parents and everybody for supporting everyone and just pulling together and making this a great year. I'll never forget it. Thanks.
All right, this is Kyle Thomas, starting slot back and defensive back. And first of all, I'd like to start off with all you upcoming freshmen that are coming in to keep this locker room clean and have your lockers like this beauty right here. Mr. Scott will be just fine and everything. And, but first of all, I'd like to start off with my most memorable moment in football, since this is like one of the final chapters here. I'd have to start out with the first chapter in Bantam Football League. I went in, didn't know what I was doing, and I became the second leading rusher in the whole Bantam League. And behind Roach, and you know where Roach is now and where I'm at, so that's just a little thing. And let's see. I don't have anything to give to anybody except, you know, I give Shane my my position. That's always a thing for him to strive for. And all you guys that are in the upcoming ranks, make sure you're up in that weight room and working hard and stuff. It works wonders for you. And I'd like to thank my parents. They've been great throughout these years and stuff. And I love them both. And I'd like to thank my brothers for beating me up when I was little and making sure that I stayed in a straight line. And I'd like to thank all the Booster Club and everything for decorating the locker room and having treats on Wednesday, or that's the moms and the Booster Club for doing all what they do and stuff. And I'd like to thank Miss Scotton for the hugs she gave after every game, win or lose. I'd like to thank the cheerleaders. They cheer us on all the time, and they put up with a bunch of our stuff. And I'd like to thank my teammates for all the all the years that I've been with them, they've been great, and they're some of my best friends, and I'd like to thank them. They're a great bunch of guys. And I just want them to know that whatever I've done, they're right there with me. And I like to thank the coaches. The coaches have been great throughout the years and stuff, and especially this year for putting up with my pouting, I guess what you'd say, Mr. Scotton. And I just have to say that. Thank you all, and that's the end.
Going wherever it leads, I'm running down. that's a chance you take when the heat's on you. And the heat is on.
ball is tipped, there you are. You're running for your life. You're a shooting star, and all the years no one knows just how hard you worked. But now it shows. In one shining moment, you reach deep inside. One shining moment, you knew you were alive. Of your heart, feel the wind in your face. It's more than a contest, it's more than a race. Win or lose, you always did your best, 'cause inside you knew that one shining moment you reached for the sky. One shining moment you knew. One shining moment you were willing to try. One shining moment you knew. Shine.